Hello and welcome to the Consulting Lifestyle Podcast to Vikrant Shorya, if I am not wrong. So Vikrant, how are you?
Hey, dude, I'm really, really doing good. Really excited to be on the show. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, you're welcome. And I'm excited also to have you. You are the first kind of expert in terms of creating and publishing everything that is related to writing books. So that's a new subject. And you're also maybe one of the first guests that I have that is based in Asia. You're based in India, so that's very, very exciting. Let's start, Vikrant, by having you sharing part of your career story for the audience.
Sure, man. So everything started when I was at around 18, and my dad asked me that, hey, like, son, what do you want to become in your life? And I just didn't want him to see me as a dumb kid and an idiot kid. So that's why I just told him that, okay, I'll be an engineer. Because in our country, like, if you are not a doctor or engineer, you're a big time failure. So I just had to tell him that, okay, I'll be an engineer, because also all of my other friends were also going to the same, like going to engineering college and all these things. So I told him, okay, I'll be an engineer. I had no clarity. I had no clue at that time, like what I'll be doing. But still I said, okay, I'll be an engineer. My dad sold his land, got my admission in an engineering college, and I was hating it, right? When I went to the engineering college, of course I was making some new friends, making some connections, but I was hating all the classes going on. Everything was extremely theoretical. And but one fine day in the third semester of my college library, I found this book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki. I still have it in over here. I know, nice. Like it's really old, but yeah. So I found it in my college library. In the very first sitting, like I just completed the entire book, but it completely changed my perception about life in finance. In the very same day, I decided that I'll be doing something of my own. And I just dropped out of the college. Mm-hmm. So I dropped out. And of course, long story short, started a company, made so many mistakes. And one of the main mistakes was I was hiring extremely fast. I hired 7 new people within first week. I lost a lot of money over there. And in 6 months, I had to shut down the company because I had no money left. So at the age of 18, I was at financial debt. And now I'm in this situation where I'm sitting in a single room apartment, searching online how to make money online, mm-hmm. with zero investment because I had no money at all. And then, of course, I figured out about self-publishing. And I had nothing to do at all. I just wrote my first book within 21 days, published that book, made around $27. It was a really big amount of money for me because, of course, it was the first money I made. It was really special for me. I still remember I was jumping on my bed. And then the second month, I also published another book. This time, I also did some marketing and I made around $440. And I was extremely happy because I was seeing some path. I was seeing the clarity on how and where to go and what to do. Some of my friends started reaching out to me that can you please help me out with the book writing publishing journey? And of course, I helped them out. Some of my Facebook friends who were entrepreneurs, they started reaching out to me with the same coaching thing. So I added a coaching fees with my support, with my consultation, and I started helping them. Then of course, when I started consulting these people, some of these people, of course, like in this process, like within 1 year, I helped thousands of people turn their ideas into a best-selling book, right? I launched several courses, eBooks. I also was doing so many consultations. Some of these people, especially entrepreneurs, coaches, consultants, they mentioned to me like, okay, everything is good. Maybe we can write a book, but really, we really don't have the time to sit down and write the book. Can you please help me do that? Mm-hmm. Then I got this idea about this market that I could maybe assemble a team of book writers, editors, publishers, marketers, and start helping these people. And this is where bestsellingbook.com born, right? I then incorporated the company in the United States, have assembled a team of writers, editors, publishers, marketers, designers, and have created this done-for-you book writing, publishing, marketing services for consultants, entrepreneurs, thought leaders, and speakers. And now we have helped hundreds and hundreds of clients turn their ideas into a best-selling book. So this is my journey, like how I came into this.
That's amazing. I have just two or three questions. I was wondering if you did announce to your dad that you dropped out of college.
Yep, that's another story. So when I dropped out of the college, but for 6 months, I didn't have the courage to tell my dad that, hey, I have dropped out. Every day, like he used to call me, because of course I moved to another city to pursue my studies. And he used to call me every single day, like that, hey son, how was your college? Every evening. And every day I used to tell him, like, oh, the college was good. And I was in a really big guilt. It was really painful to lie to him every single day. And then after 6 months, I said, okay, like I can't do it anymore. Just to tell him out, like I went back to my city. I told him that, hey, I have dropped out of the college. And I need you to imagine the scenario, like my dad is in the military. He's a really tough guy, really strong guy. And then I saw him crying for the very first time. And it was painful. My mom was crying. And my dad locked himself for 3 days in a room, was not talking to anyone, not meeting anything. It was really tough. But I knew that if I'll be doing engineering, I will not be happy after 10 years, 20 years. And then eventually he will also not be happy. So I know for a few, maybe for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, he will not be happy with me. And of course, that what happened, like for 1 year, 2 years, like he was not talking to me. Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. There was, but now he's really proud.
that's great that it turns out so positively, and it takes a huge courage to do that, and boldness to do it also very very young. And how many between that first book that you wrote in 21 days and you sold $27, you get $27 of revenue, how many years passed between that day and the moment in which you could start to really live of the income you get through your book-related business, if I say it like that?
So the first money which I made, and then when I started this company?
Yeah.
So I think 2 years.
2 years. No, that's good. That's good. I think it's, I asked that question because it's important for, because we often see the people at the kind of at the end or when they already have positive results, but we need to understand that transition is hard and takes time. So during those 2 years, you rely on your hard work and your faith in yourself. So that's long, 2 years to doing that. So that's very important. So great. So now, as you said, you have helped hundreds and hundreds of people, and people have started to reach out to you pretty quickly. So what type of books have you already worked with, or what type of projects that were kind of special have you worked with so far?
Yeah, so we have worked with several entrepreneurs, thought leaders, consultants, doctors, coaches in almost every topic you can imagine, including medical, cryptocurrency, self-help, transformation, all the different topics we have covered. And some of these topics, some of these books like were really close to my heart. So one of the book like which we did was, it was kind of like one of this person, she was a mother, she was a single mother, and she had this daughter. And she went on to, her daughter went on a trip with some of her friends, but some accident happened and her face got crushed by a boulder, due to which doctor was saying that she will not be able to survive. And then it was really painful for her, really difficult for her. But somehow, like, of course, with some all these things, like, of course, she started posting on Facebook and of course asking for prayer. But the thing is, like, eventually she got survived. She was saved. But of course, now she is on a wheelchair. The thing is, like, she transformed this story, like whatever happened with her, and created a book around it for people who are in a similar situation. Mm-hmm. Maybe they have lost their kid, their son, their husband, their wife, their mother, whatever it is. Or maybe they are their parents or their someone like they love, they're into a similar situation. Mm-hmm. And she used that book as a motivation for these people. And since then, like, she, of course, when she published that book, of course, it also helped her in her career. Now she's a motivational speaker. She also provides coaching and consultations. So not only she started helping people, but of course, like, it also helped her in her career as well. So some of these stories, like, it really impact me, my life, and my team's life as well from a deeper level. So yeah, I'm really grateful that we are also helping these kind of people share their story with the world.
Yeah, that's important, because the name of your and the name of your company is not just write a book, it's a best-selling book. So yeah. Is there a specific process that you go through with your with the authors, and how do you get them to actually write not just a book, a best-selling book?
So telling you this thing, Dio, that initially the company's name was The Books Factory.
The mindset is different then.
Yeah. So the moment when I started this company, then it was all about creating books. And so that's why, like, the name of the company was The Books Factory. But the thing is, like, when I started mastering the marketing and all of these things, my team also started growing, then all the books which we were doing with the marketing process, like, it started becoming bestsellers. And then I guess 2 or 3 years ago, like, we rebranded the entire company to bestsellingbook.com, because of course all the books which we were doing, especially the when we used to take care of the marketing, then of course the book used to become the bestsellers. And now, like, we also have helped people become bestsellers on Amazon, on Wall Street Journal, USA Today journals as well. So yeah, that's our expertise. That's why the company's name, like, we have rebranded it to bestsellingbook.com. Now, talking about the process, so of course, if you talk about the marketing, we should understand that marketing doesn't only mean, like, promoting all the different places. Mm-hmm. You also have to come up with a great product first, right? So the promotion starts with a product. So it means, like, you have to write a really great book. Maybe with the book launch, like, you can do some marketing. Maybe within first week, you can become a bestseller. But if you really have to get consistent sales, consistent number of revenue, then you really have to write a great book, which is going to help people. Mm-hmm. So the first step is having a great product. The second step is, like, once you do that, then comes the positioning. Positioning means, like, how do you position this book? You have a content, you have a story. Now, how do you use this book and make it feel like that this is something really amazing in the market? So having a really great cover, having a really great interiors and formatting, having a great title and subtitle and description of the book, reviews, all these are going to be help you position this book great out of the other books on the same topic. Mm-hmm. Right? So again, the positioning also is going to be really important play. The third is, like, doing the proper pricing. So product, positioning, and then comes the pricing. Means, like, of course, doing the proper research and find out that what's the sweet spot of the pricing in your market. Once you understand that, having that pricing, and once it is done, then comes the promotion, right? So promotion always starts with the product, then comes to the positioning, then pricing, and then, of course, we can talk about the promotion. Now, talking about the promotion specifically, there are so many steps involved. So the first is, like, of course, doing the on-page SEO. So we need to understand that Amazon also is like a Google, where people don't go to any specific category and find out any book. They simply use that search bar.
Yes.
They search for maybe self-help books. They search for motivational book, leadership book, consultation book, sales book, whatever it is. Like, they go there, they use that search bar. That's the first thing they do. So that's why, like, you have to use specific keywords in your title, subtitle, in your bio, on your description, so that your book is going to be ranking on the top of the other books, right? That's really important. So once the on-page SEO is done, then comes the other marketing, which includes maybe the free marketing or the paid marketing. Paid marketing includes, like, Amazon ads, BookBub ads, Facebook ads. You can leverage so many different platforms. So I have figured out that BookBub ads really works great. So BookBub is a platform which helps you promote your book in their subscribers. They have millions of subscribers with different, like, topics. So of course you can definitely reach out to them. Then Amazon ads, for the long term, Amazon ads really works great. We haven't seen really great success with the Facebook ads, but yeah, Amazon ads and BookBub ads do a really great job. Then one more thing is doing the free marketing. And of course for that, like, there's so many ways you can use your book to get on podcasts like this on your topic. I've seen that like podcasts are really, really great platforms nowadays to generate sales. So for example, if I'm on your on this podcast and if I start talking about my book, which is called How to Write a Bestseller, right? The book's title is How to Write a Bestseller. And of course, you're going to start asking me questions about my book. Now, people who are listening to this podcast will be very curious to know more about my book. So this is a free promotion, right? So exactly. This is what, like, find out the right type of podcast around your topic and then try to get on those podcasts. And of course, chances are if you're a published author or a best-selling author, then they will love to have you on the show because they're looking for these kind of people on their show. Mm-hmm. So, yep, this is like, if you talk about the promotion side, like how to make the book bestseller, then these are some of these things like which helps us make the book bestseller.
Okay, great. That's a great explanation, and we will make sure that we put a link to your book in the show notes of the episode as well. That's a great title, How to Write a Bestseller. I was wondering as you were mentioned. So in the audience there is more specifically B2B consultants, and I'm pretty sure you have worked with that type also of professionals. And I'm wondering for the busy professional that wants to write a book, and they call upon your services. Do you sometimes encounter some kind of misconception about writing a best-selling book? Like, do people sometimes underestimate the work that is required, or in terms of writing, or in terms of marketing? Is there any myths or any misconception about writing a best-selling book that you would like to debunk here?
So Dio, almost everyone who comes to work with us, they know subconsciously that there are so many steps involved in writing, publishing and marketing a book, right? So of course, it is not only like, if I just say writing, publishing and marketing, you feel like there are only three steps. But there are so many sub-steps like involved. For example, just in the book writing, you have to first of all come up with the title and then subtitle. Then you have to come up with the book outline. And of course, then you have to start writing the draft of all the chapters, introduction, conclusions, and then comes the editing, proofreading. And then of course, like once the book is written, then of course, there are so many steps involved, like author bio, having a great author picture, book description, then assigning an ISBN, then getting a book trailer video, then publishing the book. And of course, in the publishing as well, you have to maybe publish the book and distribute the book on Amazon, Apple Books, Kobo, iStore. There's so many different platforms you have to publish the book over there. Then once it is done, then of course, in the marketing, you have to create an Amazon Author Central page. Then you have to get the marketing, do the marketing, getting sales, reviews, do the PR and all these different things. So subconsciously, people know that there's so many steps involved. And just because they haven't done the book writing themselves, it feels daunting to them. Like they feel that like it's going to take them maybe several years. Mm-hmm. And that's why they really don't want to try that. For example, let me give you one of the incidents. So for example, if you are a consultant, maybe on a specific topic, you are a consultant and you have gathered that knowledge by doing those things for several years.
Yep.
Right. But now if I'm not a consultant on your topic, if I really have to be a great consultant like you, then I think it's going to be taking me again, like several years to become a consultant like you. Mm-hmm. Again, the same concept applies over here as well. Like if they have to write a really great book, just because they haven't done it, like it's not their skill set, right? The editing is not their skill set. The publishing is not their skill set. The marketing is not their skill set. So that's why the first best scenario could be that they should have a professional company to take care of the entire thing, if they have the money, if they have the budget. If not, still there are ways through which like they can minimize the budget and they can still do all of these things themselves. How they can do that? For example, if you talk about the book writing, people feel that they have to actually write the book, right? To really become an author, they feel that they have to write the book themselves, then and only they will be called as an author. But if you talk about this book, Rich Dad Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki, this was a ghostwritten book. So many famous book out there, like Losing My Virginity by Richard Branson. Seven Highly Effective Habits of Successful People by Stephen Covey. Almost all of these books, like all of these famous books, are ghostwritten. So these people, they really didn't have the time to sit down and write the book, but they knew that if they will start writing the book, then it's going to take them maybe a lifetime to write that kind of a quality book. But they were really great at talking about those ideas. So that's why companies like bestsellingbook.com can take your interviews, write the book for you in your voice with your personality. Now, in case if you really don't know like how to sit down and if you really don't have the budget as well, what you can do is you can maybe like once your book outline is ready, then you can simply record each, like you can start talking about that chapters. Mm-hmm. Right, you have all the major ideas, sub ideas ready. You can just start talking about those ideas for every chapters and then record it. Once it is recorded, then of course you can transcribe it. There's so many tools out there like rev.com or HappyScribe through which like you can simply have it. So now almost all the content will be there. 60-70% will be content will be there. I know like the content is going to be complete junk, but still the content is going to be there.
Yeah.
The biggest fear like people like face is the writer's block. They feel like what to write, when to write, where to start, what not to start. So, but over here, once they have all the content ready, I know like it's when even if it is completely junk, still the content is there. You just have to rearrange it and find an editor or proofreader like to fix it. So this makes the system, this makes the process easy. Mm-hmm. So yeah, like these are some of these misconceptions of people like whenever they start writing the book.
Yeah, and it's a great point about ghostwriting. I would have thought that the Rich Dad Poor Dad would have been handwritten by Robert Kiyosaki. but yeah, and it's true, when you're a busy person, you don't have the time to write a masterpiece as a book, because it really takes a lot of time and energy. So it's very important to have companies like yours in order to write those masterpieces. Now we are in 2021, June 2021, and there is still, we might come to the end in some areas of the world, but there is still the pandemic, so a coronavirus pandemic. I just wanted to know if since February, March 2020, did you see a change in terms of the demand for coming from people that would like to write books? Do you see like more people wanted to write books due to the pandemic, due to being at home and maybe not having a job?
Yeah, in 2020, like we got the maximum inquiries till this date for people like willing to write a book. Mm-hmm. But they, like most of these people, they didn't want to invest the money as well. Mm-hmm. Because of course, they also wanted to hold their money because they didn't know like what's going to happen in the future. So although everything was now they had the time to sit down and write the book. So what I did, like, we created this training for people, like which explains to them like how they can write and publish and market the book themselves. Mm-hmm. So for your audience as well, like they can check it out. Like I did some webinar last year. So if they go to bestsellingbook.com/masterclass, they can watch this, I guess, 40-45 minutes webinar from me, like where they can exactly understand how to validate their book idea, how to find out like if the idea is really good or not, how to write this book. I have explained this writing process in a very easy way. I've also explained how to create a book outline within just 2 or 3 hours and how to publish the book step by step, how to market the book and make it a bestseller. All these things have explained to them. So if they go to bestsellingbook.com/masterclass, they can watch this entire webinar for free.
Wow, that's amazing value. That's a lot of value that you have given away. And I'm sure there is also a lot of value in the book that you have written as well. And maybe the topic of giving value or providing value, why do you think, and writing a book is definitely providing value? I mean, if I am, for example, in my case, I am a digital transformation consultant since 14 years. And if I had to summarize that in a book, it's a lot of experience that you put in a book. And that book does not cost near even 1 month of salary. So it's a lot of value. A book is a lot of condensed value provided as at a very, very cheap price, honestly, compared with the content that you have. So what do you think about that? So giving value? How does giving value help a professional furthering their career or furthering their business?
So since the time when I started going and exploring these business world, there were so many experts out there, right? Like who were teaching the things, how to do this, how to do that. And they also had some back-end courses, back-end coaching program or consultation program. And when I had to decide that who is the person I have to work with, I just have had a few variables like I was tracking. The first was whether maybe the person, if he is a best-selling author on the topic, then of course that's a really great check. Then if they really provide massive value in their maybe free content like YouTube, social media, podcasts, and all these different platforms, then again, there's a great check. Then I try to work with that person. And honestly speaking, Dio, that when I enroll into their consultation or coaching program, then 90-95% of the content is completely same, mm-hmm. right? But the only difference is the structure is there. The step-by-step things are there. And that's what like the consultation people like who are consultant do. So we help people like as a consultant, like you, we help people go from point A to point B, right? And we provide them all these steps, like point, like step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So nowadays, like now, just because we are in this information age, it is really easy for people to go on Google and find out about anything. If they really want to write the book, maybe they can go on Google and then find out, okay, how to write a book. But the thing is like, why still people don't take action? Because they need a personal assistant. So honestly speaking, like I am a really kind of, since last 10 years, I wanted to do martial arts, right? And I was exploring like, okay, who's going to be my trainer? And I wanted to hire a personal trainer, right? 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. And I started Googling. I started using Google and there were so many options over there. There were hundreds and hundreds of personal trainer about like who were training martial arts. Now, I went for that person who was offering something for free on the social media thing. I mean, he was having so many different classes. He was having so many tutorials about so many martial arts training for free. So I called him, I hired him, and now he comes over here and trained me for the martial arts. So the thing which I want to explain over here is offering the value is really, really important for the consultant so that they can establish the authority. And of course, writing a book is also one of the way. So of course, I know that like if you're going to be publishing a book for $5 or $10, even if like thousands of people will be buying it, still you will not be like if for $5, if 1,000 people will be buying it, like you are just making $5,000.
Yeah.
But out of those 5,000 people, maybe 50 people will be definitely calling you or emailing you wanting to work with you, because they have read through the content and now they see you as an expert on this topic. They really want a personal assistant and helping hand, which is going to help them go from point A to point B, mm-hmm. right? And that's where the book is going to be kind of the first step where they are investing something in them. And then you have established your authority and you have provided all the value to them. But at the same time, now they see you as an authority on the topic, because of course, Brian Tracy has said this several years ago that if you want to become an author on your topic, then if you want to become an authority on your topic, then you have to become an author, because in authority, like the first few letters are author.
Author.
Right. So this is how like writing a book is going to help consultant get more clients, raise their visibility and reach out to more and more people.
That's very important. We want to differentiate ourselves on the market, but also have some kind of legacy about the career that we have had. Like, okay, I've worked 10 years in that field, and you know what? I also have written a book about it that summarizes a little bit all the things that I know. I think it's great. How do you see the future of the industry? Because I'm not an expert in the industry at all, but I know that there are a lot more formats of books like ebooks, Kindle, etc. I don't know, how do you see the future of the industry evolving, the industry of book publishing and trying to write bestsellers?
Yeah, so 20 years ago, it was all paperback or hardcover. people used to go and go to libraries, and they used to like go and find the book from the bookstores. So it was all paperback. They used to purchase the physical book. Now, after like after 10 years, like 10 years ago, everything started shifting to the ebooks. Now, after launching the Kindle device and having some great smartphones and laptop, like this, people started reading more ebooks. So like if 70 to 80% of the market was going to the ebook. Now, again, there's a market shift from the last 2 or 3 years. Now people are shifting to audiobooks, right? Now, just thanks to the podcast industry, now people are getting used to like they have plugged themselves, the earphone, and then they start listening to some of their favorite book, which they can't read. So maybe they are driving and they are listening. So they are training their subconscious mind, even when they are doing something else, right? So this is where the market is shifting. And I think maybe within just 2 or 3 years, everything, like maybe 70 to 80% of the market could be for the audiobook.
Yeah. That's great. Indeed, audio is taking more and more space. And indeed, I personally don't listen to much audiobooks. I'm still prefer to read them. But yes, that's definitely where the market is going. So,
What I personally do is I buy a paperback or an ebook along with an audiobook. So I start listening to that and I start reading that as well. So I use two different senses to take the same information, which makes that information be in my mind for a longer period of time. Mm-hmm. So I find it really valuable if I do that.
good tip. I think that's something I should try. And actually I have a question. What are your top five, your favorite books ever? Like, I'm just curious about it.
Yeah, sure. So the first book is, of course, Rich Dad Poor Dad, because of course it completely changed whatever I do. The second book I would say is The Power of Now.
Oh yeah, right. From Eckhart Tolle.
Eckhart Tolle. So I would say that for every different thing, like of course I have a different book. So Rich Dad Poor Dad, like which helped me started my career. Then The Power of Now, like of course which helped me some in my spirituality journey. And then in the marketing, there was a book by one of my good friend called Ellen Dibb. The person's name was Ellen Dibb, and the book's title was The One Page Marketing Plan. And let me tell you, like, so last year in pandemic, like when it started, I found this book on Amazon. It was doing really well. I purchased the book. I read the entire book within 2 days, I guess. And then I emailed the author that no matter what your coaching fees or consultation fees is, like, I want to hire you.
Wow.
And he replied to me. And then we started working together. His coaching fees was $3,000 per month. I don't care. I really want to work with you because I see you as an expert, and I think you can definitely help me out. So yeah, this is the power of the book. So yeah, answering your question. So the first book, Rich Dad Poor Dad, The Power of Now, The One Page Marketing Plan, which helped me with the marketing. One book I think, which is not that famous, I would say, is it was about postures, right? I really don't remember the title, but yeah, I have read it 2 or 3 times. So it was from an Indian author, mm-hmm. and which helped me like with how to stand, how to walk, how to sleep, how to sit, how to have a great posture. Because of course, like whenever we sit, especially on the couch, like we are like this.
Yeah.
And the thing is, like, maybe we don't notice this, like our posture completely changes our mentality, completely changes like what kind of thoughts are going to be coming. If we have a strong, great posture, then we see that like our mood is going to be uplifting. But if we'll have something like this, then it's not going to be working out. Like for you, you will feel lethargic. You will not feel good. You will feel that, okay, everything is not good in your life. So that's why like that book definitely helped me out with understanding how does that work. There was one more book by, I really don't remember, but like it was about tidying up. It was like the author's name, like author was a Korean. Mm-hmm. And that book was really famous, The Art of Tidying or something, like how do you have just minimalistic things in your home, in your workplace and all these things. So it really helped me out as well. So these, I would say, are going to be the top five books. But yeah, like there's so many books, but yeah, these are going to be the top five books for me.
Okay. Yeah, that's amazing. And of course, the behind, for the people that will see the video, the back, we see your book, How to Write a Bestseller, a very nice cover. So that was a great interview. I believe that for consultants, it's important not to underestimate maybe the value of writing a book, but also, as you said, we are ourselves consultants because we help companies to implement or execute the things we mm-hmm. are most qualified to do. And that's the same for a book. No, not everybody can write a book, but mm-hmm. maybe not everybody can easily write a best-selling book. And that's where your company provides value. So my last question would be for you, Vikrant, because you do some kind of consulting with other professionals. So what does having a consulting lifestyle mean?
So for me, the consulting lifestyle is having a freedom to work with people you want to work. Also, of course, as I mentioned that as a consultant, like we help people go from point A to B. So we have already covered that journey from point A to B. And now, just because now we have covered that, like now we know like what are the ups and downs, what are the things. It is also very fulfilling to work and help those people who are still on point A, struggling with their life or business. But with your expertise, if you're going to be helping them go from point A to B, that's a really fulfilling thing, right? So so I would say that it is going to be freedom and having a fulfilled life.
That's so good. And if anyone that is listening to the episode would like to get in touch with you the same way you get in touch with the author of the One Page Marketing Plan, where should they go?
So there are a few things like which you can do. So the first thing, which of course I've already offered something like a great resource, like a yes. webinar, bestsellingbook.com/masterclass. Mm-hmm. One more thing which I want to offer your audience is a checklist, which is going to be a step-by-step, like which will be having a step-by-step plan, which explains the entire journey from book writing to editing, publishing, marketing with a logical sequence. So you can download that checklist, print it out, paste it on the wall, and then start writing the book. It's going to be making your publishing journey way easier. This checklist also comes with the blueprint, which explains how to use this checklist. So if they go to bestsellingbook.com/checklist, they can download it and print it out, this checklist, which will be, I'm sure, that very, very helpful. So, yep. And also they can check out what do we do, like if they really need help, our professional book writers, publishers, marketers in their team to turn the ideas into best-selling book, they can simply visit bestsellingbook.com, schedule a call with one of our author strategists, and then they can understand your book writing and publishing goals. And then, of course, you can create a custom plan for you, which can help you on your publishing journey. So, yep, this is how they can find me.
Amazing, amazing. And all those links that you have mentioned, the checklist, the masterclass, the link on the website, we'll put them all in the show notes, of course. And it was really a great episode. It made me think also about me and maybe trying to write a best-selling book. And I'm sure I'm not the only one who is starting to think about it after listening to you. So thank you very much, Vikrant. And we talk again soon.
Thank you so much, Dio. Like, it was amazing talking to you. Thank you so much.
Yeah, for me too. Thank you.